Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about how to use for loop in Python. People have studied for loop in many other programming languages. The same logic will be applied in Python as well. Maybe use the for loop that the C programming, C++, Java programming, or any other programming languages. So, what is the concept of the for loop applied in the other programming languages? The same logic, the same method we are going to follow in that Python. But the procedure applying for loop slightly different from other programming. So, logical difference. In other program language, and I want to give the small hint, the for loop in the Python. Okay, good. Now I'll give some introduction about the for loop. Before entering the for loop, we need to understand what is the objective and what is the learning outcome. The objective of session is to study about for loop and the uses. What is the learning outcome? You will be able express different decision making procedure with the use of for loop. Good. Now this is the structure of, what is the structure of the for loop, and this is a common structure, and you can take any program language. This is a common structure of the for loop. The loop will enter here. Okay, the loop will enter here. Now it will check the either the element is, the last element is reached or not. This is the condition, right? If the last element is reached, if the condition is true, and immediately it will exit the loop. Suppose the last element does not reach, right? So now what is the meaning? The condition is still, it is continuous, means the condition is false. So last element does not reach, so it will move to the body of the for loop, and the whatever the within the for loop the statement is, either one statement or more than one statement, the statement will be executed and it will come to the, okay. So this is the process of the for loop, or the structure of the for loop. The loop will be executed until the condition is going to reach the last element, the for loop. Now we'll see the for loop declaration in the Python. The for loop declaration, it's a very simple, and compared to other programming languages, it's very simple, right? And you don't want to specify that any additional requirement. Just we are going to specify only that for one variable we need to declare, right? And this is the variable, and this is the where you are going to take the value, that is called. Now this is what the for loop declares. So for I in some range, some in the sum, you are going to take some items from the somewhere. What is the somewhere? Maybe it may be a list, or it may be a list, or it may be a tuple, or it may be a dictionary, or it may be a set, or it may be a string. So this is the condition we are going to make. So print the, so see this example, print the list item using for loop. So now we have declared the one list, right? So animals equal to lion, bear and tiger declared. So list is within a square bracket, it is declared. Now we are going to print the list item using for loop, that's all. So this is a user defined, one variable is declared. Okay, the user defined one variable is declared. Okay, now in that variable, now we are going to get the some values. So we are going to take the items where from the, that's why we need to specify the list name. Just to print the variable name. So anim list, what will happen? So the for loop, it will start from 0, 1, 2. So one by one item it will go. So what will happen? So automatically the increment will be, Okay, no increment. So one step will move automatically. We don't want increment, but there is an option is also is there. We will see the next slide. So the list will start from zero. So it will start one and it will print lion. Then it will go next. Then it will go. So then automatically the for loop it will. Very simple example. Print the list types using for loop. Similarly, you can print the dictionary item using for loop. You can print the tuples items using for loop. Just we can same logic, but we need to declare the tuple item. We need to declare the list item. Now, come to the next example. In this example, what we are going to discuss, in this example, we are going to see that example of just print the dictionary item using for loop. Here, print the tuples items using for loop. So this is the dictionary item. What is the dictionary? It should be with a curly braces and it will be so flowers, rose, lotus and jasmine. Just use the for loop, just print the dictionary item. Okay. Now what is the third in this example? In this example we are going to display the tuples items using for loop. Just use that your tuples is declared with the parenthesis. Just print the tuples item. So this is a very simple example using the for loop. Now I will open the Python code. I will show some examples in that how to print the list, how to print the dictionary, how to print the tuples using for loop. I will go to the Python program. Right. Just I'll open the Python code and this is the Python code. Now I'm going to, what is the type? For example, flower. Okay. I'm typing flower to just to use the parenthesis. Parenthesis, this is the what? The tuple. Now I'm just declaring jasmine. Okay. Rose. Lotus, right? Parenthesis. Now we are going to use a for loop. For, right? I in flower. What is a flower? Flower is the what? The tuple. Now put the colon. So now you remember the colon. We previously we used where? In the where? In the if condition and the function we use this colon. The same colon also applicable in the for loop as well. So once a colon is declared, the next statement what will happen? So the space that the intent space automatically it will come in that the this following statement belongs to the particular for loop. Now we are going to use the print I. That's the way you can use it. The full items are when I. So better you can we use this one. Item is okay. So just save the thing, run the program, you will get the answer. What the tuple item is jasmine will be printed, zeroth position, next is rose is printed, next is lotus is used. Just we are going to print the okay. Now this is the print the now. I'm going to use the same for the list. So list in the sense what we need to do. List in the for example country equal to open a square bracket. Square brackets mean the sense what is it is the list. Okay. List where it gone. Of course, I mean plus A plus A E. That's square bracket complete. Now for J in go entry country colon of print of J. What it will print? So it will just save the program, run the program F5. now you will get the answer USC, US, UK, and UK is coming. So it will where into the with the for loop we are printing the items from the pair list. Similarly for the dictionary. Okay, now I'll go back to the screen. So in the screen now this is the simple example. Now I'll move to the next example. What is this example? And this example print the string characters using for loop. So there is a one string character is there. There is a one string is there. From the string we are going to print the character by character, one character. What is it? So see the location LOC is a variable. So Australia declared. Now print LOC. What will so it will print A, U, S, F, separate character will be declared. So with use of the for loop, we can print the character by character from the string. Okay, this is one example. I'll move to the next example. What is in this example? This example just change the list items from lower case to upper case. You're going to change the lower case to upper case. So in the list item, see the items are declared in that lower case. Now this lower case, we are while going to print that item, you should be converted into upper case. What we need to do, so that animals we are going to taking, okay, animals, just when you going to print, just use the upper method. Now while use the upper method dot upper, automatically when you are going to print, it will be printed like this, lion, bear and tiger. So that you are while printing your list item, it will be converted into uppercase. Similarly, for this example, change a list item from uppercase to lowercase. While printing, it should come with the lowercase. Right? See here, the lion, bear, and the tiger, it is there in the capital letters. While printing, we are converting into the lowercase. The lowercase, so while printing, it come. Okay. So what the method we are going to use, the upper and the lower method. So the upper and lower methods are using to convert the lower to upper, upper to lower in the, but it is happening where in the for loop. We are not converting one by one, just we will insert into the loop and loop will taking care of one by one convert the x. Right, now come to the next concept. The next concept is break statement. What is a break statement? As we know very well the meaning of the break. The break in the sense stop, right? Suddenly need to stop, right? Instantly we need to stop that loop iteration. So when you use that break statement, and what will happen in the, your loop will be stopped, right? Your loop will be stopped at the moment and before complete the all other iteration, immediately it will stop. Just imagine there are 10 items are there. You need to stop when the condition reached the fifth position. When the condition reached the fifth position, immediately it need to stop it and it will come out from the loop. It will not continue the rest of the items. How it is possible? Very simple. We need the one small statement that is called break. Right, the loop is execute enter and checking the last element is reached or not. If it is not reached the last element, and now it will go to the condition, so it will check again if it is break or not. Have we used the break or not? If use break, immediately it will stop, and even though the condition still it is the possibility to continue, it will stop. That is the nature of the break. So instantly it will stop, suddenly it will stop, and it will come out from the. So what will happen? So if it is break, yes, it will exit from the loop and it will continue the rest of the statements. Okay. And if it is break is not available, and it will again it will continue inside the for loop and it will continue the for. Let us see this sample of this one. So sample. Now there are two samples I gave. One is called exit the loop using break statement after the print and before the print. What is the difference? Let me see, explain. Okay. First, see this. The first one, List is declared. Lion, bear, tiger, cow, and the horse is declared. Now in this animal, now we are going to use the for anim in that animals, right? Just first print the complete list, right? First print the, right? We are going to try to print the complete list of animals. But while the after that, now still it is there all statement within the for loop. Print, we are try to print. Now in the between, we are making one condition. If anim list equal to cow, suppose in that for loop, when the items taking from that list, if a item is equal to cow, if equal to cow, immediately it will break. Okay, immediately. Once if the for loop will find any one other item cow in the list, immediately the system will stop that iteration. It will come out from the loop. See this example. What is this example? In this example, so first lion will come, so it will print. When bear will come, it will print, because every time it will check lion equal to cow, no false. Now it will continue the for loop. Bear equal to cow, now false. Again it will continue. Tiger equal to now is false. Again it will continue for loop. When the cow it will reach, no condition is true. What will happen? It will print, because first print after checking, so it will print the cow. Now it will, the condition is true, now break, immediately it will come out, this horse will not exist. Clear? And this is the use of the breaks. See, this is another example. Now this print is we used before the break, now we are using the print is after the break. What is the difference? So see, animals again, it will print lion, and now because now first is checking the if condition. Now next it bear will come, it is checking bear equal to cow or not. Tiger equal to cow, now it will check. Now the cow's condition is satisfied. What will happen? Break this statement, the print statement will execute, even the cow will not come. So the printing position is very important when you use the breaks before or after. Okay? This is the use of the break statement. The break statement is one of the very good example when you want to stop. So I will show you one sample in the Python program, and you will get more. Okay, I will go to the Python program, right? The Python program, I will remove all the things here. For an example, numbers, right? Numbers equal to 1 and 5 comma 7 comma 8 comma 10 comma 10 comma 3 comma in something else. Okay, now list is prepared. Now I'm going to use a for num in verse and right print of num. Okay, now I'm going to use a for loop. If num equal to 10, okay, then now I'm using a break, finish. Now what will happen? So what is the output is supposed to come? Supposed to come 1, 5, 7, 8, 10 should. Okay, because print I'm used before. Just save the program, control S. I'm just run the program. Now see that output. 1, 5, 7, 8, 10 is print. So the 10 is also, we are use the print statement. So immediately once you reach the print statement, your control is stopped to continue the rest of the iteration. Okay. Now I will go back to the previous PPT. Right. So this is an example. So using the exit loop. Now we'll come to the next important concept, continue. So continue statement. What is this continue statement? The continue statement, it is just opposite to the break. So if it is a break, it will stop. In continuation of new and break statement, loop, and there is a one special function there in the for loop is called range. So range is one of the main function in the for loop. So range, what does mean? And range, so where to start, where to end. We are going to specify it when you're going to run the for loop, and how many times would you like to execute the iteration, you need to fix it. That's why we are fixing the range. The range function is used to execute the set of code in the specified number of times. How many times you are going to execute the particular set of code, the range. The range functions can be represented in the three different ways. What's the different way? Three different ways. Number one is directly specify the stop value, right? The range in a bracket you are specifying 10. The loop will be executed 10 times. The sequence will be executed the 10 times. What is the second method? Then you are going to specify starting value and the ending value, stop value and the start value. So the your loop will start that specified value and it will stop in the specified value. So start and so only two parameter. The third one is there are three parameter. One is called start value, second is stop value and the step value. The start value, the loop will start from the starting position as per your number specified. And loop will be stopped as per the number specified, and the stop value as per the size. So it will increment how many times in the increment unit is specified. That is called step value. Okay, one step or two step or three step or four step unit is specified. What about the first and second? By default, automatically it will increment by one step. Okay, so first and second method. The increment value automatically it will increment one step value, but in the third step you are exclusively you are specifying the value. So based on your value it will the loop will be it will move for one step or two step. Okay, now in this part now I'm going to talk about that range. So what we will discuss now, so suppose you declare the range of 10. So loop will execute from 0 to 9 total 10 times. So by default the increment value by the third one. Come to the second method, start value and stop value. You are going to specify the start and so the starting positions starting value 3. Okay, so the loop will execute 3 to 10 and 10 will not come because it will come up to 9 only. So it is automatically it will print 1. So range again the start and stop and step value. So how is declare range 3 comma 10 comma 2. The starting is 3 and it is going to up to 10. 10 in this is 10 will not come, so up to 9. So similarly, how is the range? Always range will come in the before, it will stop at the before the value. What we specify 2 in the sense step, so 2 values increment will come. So this is the three ways of the for loop. Okay. Now see some example. For number in range 3, for number range 3 in the sense, by default, so automatic the number value, initial value assigned as 0. So range of 3 in the sense, so when you do this program, you will get answer 0, 1, 2. So initial value 0 by automatically by default it will assign 3 in the sense. So the loop will be executed 3 times 0, 1, 2. So it will increment 1 by 1, 0, 1, 2, 8. So this is the one example. Come to the second example. We are specifying the starting position and the ending start value and the end value. Here the start value 1 and the loop we are going to execute up to the 5 times. So that is so 1, 2, 3, 4 will come. 5 will not come. So before the so it start from the 1, 2, 3. Now come here. Now in this position, now 1 comma 10 comma 2. So the starting 1 up to 10 and 2 to value we are increasing. What will happen? So it will print 1 and 2 times size jump will, so iteration will jump 2 times, so 3 will come and 3, 5 will come, and when increment now, so it will jump 2 to value 7. So 1, then after that, so 1 after that, what will happen? 1 plus 2, then after that, what is the last value? Plus 2, and what is the last value? Plus 2, it will go up to, okay, this is the, so 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, what is it? This is the odd number. So similarly, suppose you want to print the even number. So 2 to 10, so it will print 2, 4, sorry, it should be 6, okay, 2, 4, 6 and 8 will be, okay. Now, what about the next example? We are going to print the value descending order. What is the descending order? So from the 5 to 0, so 5 to 0, we need to use minus 1, 5 it will print. 4, 3, 2, 1, it is so minus 1. Automatically the value will be reverse order. It will, so minus 1, so it will decrement 1 by 1, it will print. Now, what is this example? In this example, we are going to print an alternative items from the list. One item need to skip and next item need. One item need to skip and next item will. So we are going to print the list item, the alternative. For that, what we need to do? First, we need to declare the list item. Now for num equal to range of starting from 0, and we need to find the length of animal, total how many items we need to find out, total items available in the list item. So for that, what we need to use the length method, length animals comma the 2. So what is our aim? Our aim is we are going to alternatively we are going to print that. So 0 it will print, after that 1 skip and 2 will come, next 3 will skip, 4 will print, like this. So finally just to print animals of number, that is called index position. What will, a lion will print, then bear will skip, tiger will come, now cow will skip, monkey will come, now horse will skip, dog will print. So this is the way the alternative list will be printed from the pair. Now, what is this method? And this is another one more example. So, sum of even numbers from 1 to t. Sum of even numbers. We are going to sum only the even numbers, not the odd numbers. The number from 1 to 20. What are the sum of even numbers? First of all, we need to identify what are the even numbers from 1 to, just for our purpose, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 18, okay, 220. So that we take it the 20 as well. Now for this is the even numbers from 1 to 20, and for that this is we are going to make the sum, right? For the what the logic we need to use, first of all we need to declare the one variable sum equal to 4. For number in the range of starting from 0 up to 21. Why it's 21? It will come up to 20. Okay. Step, what is the step? It will go one by one. Even though you can declare like this also, 0, 21 also same. So you, if you don't want to specify 11, 0, 21 also similar. Okay. Now, for that, you need to identify the even numbers. If you first of all you need to identify the even numbers, what we need to do, we need to make that, use that modulus operator. We are going to check either the particular number is modulus divided by 2, in the sense if remainder value 0, it means that particular number is even numbers. So now once even number is identified, we are going to add the number, okay, one by one. So first number, what the first value is 0, so it will not be counted. Now first again 1 will come, it will do, now it is condition false, it will again 2 will come, 2 modulus equal to 0, okay, great. Now it will come. So now 0 plus 2, sum is 2 will come first time. Okay, Second, 3 will come, it will not be counted. 4 will come, now sum. Like that, all the even numbers added one by one, one by one, one by one. Finally, you get the answer 110. So the sum of even numbers from is 110 will come. This program will explain about how to sum of even numbers from 1. Okay, it's count one by one, one by one, one by one. Answer for this. Okay, right. Now we will see how to use else in for loop. You cannot think that else is possible only in the if loop. Else is possible for loop as well in the Python program. So what is the use of this else part? The else part will be executed when the loop is completed. When that all the iteration is completed once in the for loop, immediately in the else part will be. Okay, not like a if condition. What is the if the condition is false? Now else part will be executed where? In the if condition. But here the for else, the else part executed will be executed once all the iteration is completed. Now else part will come. See this example. So to print from 5 to 1. So 5 is entered here. Okay. 5 is entered here. 0 minus 1. So what will happen? So it is starting from 5. It will go up to that 0. Not the 0. Before the 0 and minus value. Now it will print 5, it will print 4 come, 3 come and 2, 1. Finally, all the iterations when the condition is for condition is stopped. Okay, all the iterations completed. When you're going to come out from the loop, right, in the for loop, now that else part will be executed. So similarly, else colon, now we need to write the. So I will show one example in the Python. Just I will open the Python code. Okay, so this is the Python code. Then Python code, just I will write the new code. An example for num in range from 20 comma up to 0 comma minus 2. Okay, we are decrementing the value minus minus, right? Print num. Okay. Now after that I am writing the else part, else colon print and third, right? Just finish. Run the program. First save the program. Run the program. What is the answer you will get? Get the answer like this. Sir, paste it. You will get the answer like this. Sir, how is the answer? See that 20, 18, 16, 14, 12, 10, it is a reverse order, it is come. Loop, finally the loop is completed. Okay, so this is the else part in the where? The Python, Python for. Okay, now we'll move to the next one. Nested for loop. What does mean nested for? The loop within the loop. The loop within the loop. The loop is one for loop within the another for loop. So what is the difference? So first the inner loop will be executed, then after the outer loop will execute. Okay, the only first time only outer loop will execute. Now after that it will come inner loop. Once inner loop is completed, now it will go to the outer loop. Now again it will come to the inner loop, executed completely, now will go to the outer loop. Outer loop execute, again come to the inner. So in and out, in and out, in and out. Okay, so loop inside the another loop, it is the nested. So inner loop will be executed one time for each iteration of the outer loop. So every iteration of the outer loop one time, then inner loop will execute. See this example. That is a one list is. What is the list? Size equal to small, medium, big. This is the one list. Another list, car name, Toyota, Benz, BMW. There are two lists we have created. Now, we are going to use the two loops now for A in size. This is the outer loop. A in size. What will happen? The small, medium, big will come. But now inside the one for loop, we open another for loop for B in car name. Okay. Now what? Now we are going to print it. Print A comma B. What is the A comma B? What is the A? A it should come that size and B it come the car name. How the answer will come? See the first time. So only one time it will execute the outer loop. After it will go to the inner loop. See the small. What is the small? That is the outer loop. One time executor. So small Toyota, small Benz and small BMW execute. Now that when they reach the inner loop is false. Again the outer loop execute. Outer loop execute and it will increment one value. It will the next it will medium Toyota Benz will come. Again the inner loop is finished. Now it will go to the outer loop. Again the third big Toyota Benz it will come. So like that the nested loop left. So size and car name. Now we are printed. The logic is the outer loop will executed and the inner loop will be executed one time for the each iteration of the outer loop. Okay, so the concept. So the for loop is one of the good advantage. So with use of for loop, we can do many programs in that for loop concept in the Python. Okay, so try the program and you just practice more program and you will get more clear about the